Welcome to Easton's Bow Hunting Boot Camp. I'm Fred Eichler, and I want to talk to you about trail cameras. We've all seen all kinds of different trail camera photos. Some are absolutely incredible, some are horrible, and a lot of them are just pictures of the sky, branches moving, a mouse, a bird, a bee, a moth, all kinds of things that you didn't intend to get pictures of. The main reason we set out trail cameras is to help us be successful bow hunters. So I'm going to talk to you about some of the things that I do to help get great photos, great videos from my trail cameras. Bottom line is trail cameras are out there in the field 7 days a week, 24 hours a day, and they're helping you figure out what's in the area that you're going to be hunting. There's all kinds of little tips to get better trail camera pictures. One, and probably the most important, is I try not to ever face my cameras due east or due west. The obvious reason is the sun comes up in the east, sets in the west, and if your camera's facing that, a lot of times that light directly into the camera will set off and trigger it. Same thing with the west. The other problem with facing a camera east or west is if an animal comes in, a bull elk, a whitetail, mule deer, bear, turkey, whatever it is, and that camera's facing into the sun, that animal's gonna be shadowed and you may not be able to see the size of the beard, the size of the antlers, the size of the horns, whatever it is you're trying to capture. So I try and set my cameras off a little bit, but never face them due east or due west. The other thing to make sure of, besides that there's no tall grass, limbs, or brush that could accidentally trigger the camera in case the wind's blowing or in a storm, is to mount your camera on a sturdy, stable platform. This is on a metal H brace. That's not gonna move in a windstorm. Unfortunately, I've set up cameras in the past on small little limbs or branches that I thought would be perfect, and then the slightest breeze gives me all kinds of false images. So setting your camera on a stable platform will help you get less accidental triggers. So try and pick, when you can, a stable platform. If you don't have one, sometimes I've driven T-posts into open fields to have a stable platform to set a camera. I've also set up wooden fence posts in the middle of a field to try and have a stable platform. So a stable platform for that camera is super important. I run cameras all year. I don't just want to know what the deer and the elk and the bear and the lions and all the other animals I'm looking to watch are doing during the season. I want to get patterns. I want to see what they're doing all year. Where are they feeding? What trails are they using? When are they shedding their antlers? When are they growing their antlers? When are they dropping babies or calves? I like to keep an eye on everything with my trail cameras. I'll leave my cameras out 4 to 6 months at a time, especially in the off season, without ever going to check on them. Because of good batteries like lithium ions, they're a little extra money, but I can keep those cameras running for 4 to 6 months without having to go check on them. The other thing I do is I get SD cards with high capacity storage. If I'm gonna leave a camera out 4 to 6 months, I want an SD card with high capacity. So it'll store all those videos and all those photos without filling up. There's nothing like going in to check a trail camera that you're excited to see images on and see that either your batteries have died or that your SD card was full and you missed some awesome opportunities. I also never set up a trail camera perpendicular to a trail like this. I want to quarter it to the trail or to the crossing so I can get the animal coming in, get the full image of the animal. Same way, if it's going the other way, I can get the full image of the animal. I try and set up my trail cameras for every option. I also set it up for multi-pictures. If there's multiple animals traveling together, for example, I want to get them all. I want to get the first deer and the last deer. I really like the cameras that allow me to shoot high-def video with audio, or ones that'll give me a super good photo, a lot of resolution, whether it's nighttime or daytime. So if you've got the option on your camera, run video mode. It'll tell you more of the story. Really fun to look at. If you're just gonna run photos, get the highest resolution photos that you can because you're gonna be able to see more detail in those animals. Besides that, trail camera pictures and videos to me are art. I put pictures like that on my wall. I've got some amazing trail camera pictures because I take my time and I think about my setup before I ever put the camera out. So if you use some of these tips, I hope it'll help you get better video or pictures on your trail camera.